India's list of celebrities runs long. However, very few among these noted personalities of India evoke conflicting feelings of fear, respect and awe together in the minds of superpowers. Awul Pakir Jainala bin Abdul Kalam, or A.P.J. Abdul Kalam as he is known as, is one such personality. The main force behind India's first successful satellite launch in 1980, and the person behind India's current ambitious missile program. Dr. Kalam says his inspiration comes from history books, which tell the fact that the world's first war rockets were made in India.
I was always enamored about this battle, you know, at Seringapatam. There was a big battle between British and Indian forces. And so it is written some of the rockets used there, you know. So I was interested how in 17th century, you know, 18th century, how did they make these rockets? So I went to that place, Seringapatam. Seringapatam, it's called. So I went to that place, tried to find out, you know, what is, who would have done that. But you know, as usual in India, we don't maintain the history. So I have to build a lot of informations. Then one guy from abroad, USA, he had done some research on Indian ancient rockets. There he talks about India's first war rocket. He writes there, this war rocket is available in a museum, artillery museum of Warwick Museum. So I went there and I saw that war rocket, a small fellow, tiny fellow. You know, it was frightening in those days. They defeated the British in the first war, Seringapatam War was defeated. And second war, of course, Tipu was killed. But when they opened his fort, they found hundreds of rockets ready to fire. You know, that means technology, the method of making the rocket, it was there in India.
Determined to carry forward the tradition and bring glory back to India, Kalam joined the Indian Space Research Organization and later Defense Research and Development Organization.
It is somewhere in 1973, I was appointed as a project director for India's first satellite launch vehicle, which will put a Rohini satellite in the orbit. And in 1980, July, 18th July, we have successfully launched. Of course, every program, there will be a technological problems will come in. Our earlier attempt in 1979, we had a failure. The SLV-3 could not inject the Rohini satellite in the orbit. But in July 1980, it was successfully launched, and many successes followed. This is my first organization, ISRO, where I worked for nearly 25 years. Then I was asked to take over Defense Research and Development Laboratory, that's situated in Hyderabad of DRDO. I think it's 1982. And there we have to evolve a missile program and design and develop five types of missiles: Prithvi, Trishul, Akash, and Nag, and also a technology demonstrator, Agni.
What makes Kalam stand a cut above others is his humanistic view of life, leadership qualities, coupled with determination to strengthen the motherland.
Type of person whom you look at around somewhere else, then you will feel you have not met such persons before. And that's if you want me a one sentence type of expression. She's a sort of a unique person.
I know Dr. Kalam for more than 25 years. And what I see in him is, he knows every scientist, young scientist, who contributes for the project. And he builds him around his strength. So the scientists feel that he is monitored by the chief of the organization. And he gets into the program more involved, and he goes and reports to him what he has done. So slowly he builds him around his strength and makes him great. Today, if I look back, I see more than 50 to 60 leaders are born in India because of his association. I have seen him in SLV-3, I have seen him in the missile program, and the thing which I appreciate is that he believes that everybody has got strength. He doesn't reject anyone.
One of Kalam's main tasks at the DRDO is the indigenous production of 5 families of missiles under the integrated guided missile program.
All the system, 4 missile system, it's intended for all the Army, Navy, Air Force. And the Prithvi we have completed the program. Threshold airing completion, that is surface to air missile, and Nag and Akash, it will go into deployment by 1998. So it's going as per schedule.
What makes these 5 weapons unique is that for the first time, India has produced missiles totally indigenously, with no technical or other help from any other nation, and despite restrictive world policies like the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty, NPT, Missile Technology Control Regime, MTCR, and the Comprehensive Test Ban Treaty, CTBT.
The developed countries, about 8 to 10 countries, they joined together. They established what is called Missile Technology Control Regime, MTCR, specifically directed towards these 2 programs, Agni and the Prithvi. Now, how do we combat this type of technological control regimes? One answer, once you become self-reliant, then the people respect.
But will these missiles be able to combat the sophisticated weapons from other countries?
India is self-reliant in missile technology. We can design, we can develop, we can lead to production any type of missiles.
This, unfortunately, is often criticized by detractors who say that a poor country like India can ill afford to spend so lavishly on space and missile technologies. Dr. Kalam answers.
Space technology, it gives a meteorological forecast, it gives the communication, it finds out the natural resources on the earth, so it's a part of societal uplift. As far as the defense research development concerned, to do a peaceful work, you have to defend the country. For that, you need the strength. Okay? So I get a feeling if India is not poor, people thinking is poor. Okay? Only our thinking is poor. If we think big, we can also equally become a great country.
The missile production technology has resulted in a number of developments in other fields too, most prominently in the medical field.
There is Agni. In the tip you will see a heat shield. There is a material called carbon composites. They're very light, you know. It stands about 3500 degrees Celsius outside when it's re-entered hypersonic speed. But still inside temperature will be like this room temperature. And that material we have developed for that purpose. So one of my friends, medical professor, doctor, he saw that material so light, and he took me to his orthopedic hospital in Hyderabad. He told me, see, such a light material. He showed some of the young girls and boys who were having the FROs, floor reaction orthoses, or calipers, you know, for the polio patients. It went 4 kilograms each caliper 4 kilogram. Then we both of both team, that is my team and his medical team, my technical team, his medical team, they worked together and brought out their firewalls for the polio patients. It weighs 400 grams, 4 kilogram, 1/10. The children were very happy to wear it, very light. So whatever we do, it gets into the defense technology spin-off, like FROs, cardiac pacemaker, and cardiac catheter, now as cardiac stent. But the medical team and DRDO, science technical team, they work together and we'll succeed. We are succeeding.
Another aspect of Dr. Kalam, which very few know about, is that this strong man of India is also a sensitive poet.
Poetry, it gives you, what I can say, some bliss. You know, when you are working in various areas, difficult areas, not difficult areas, it puts you, it smoothens your thoughts and ideas. So it's an outlet, I will say it's an outlet. Of all resources, the ignited mind or ignited soul is more powerful compared to any resource on the earth, above the earth, and under the earth.
Dr. Kalam's vision for his country stems from his search for these ignited souls among his countrymen.
If you are to be great, if the nation has to become great, we have to think big. Okay, we have to think big. We should not be beaten by various constraints put to various nations. I get a feeling we must have for next 20-25 years a vision before us, that is how the country will become self-reliant in various sectors of life, how we upgrade the life, that is a good life for the nation, how it will come. It can come only by technology. Technology is the tool. So our policy makers to capture as a technology the best tool, it can give the quick results. So technology vision is the best solution for the nation.